Hi, this is Pat Love with Pat's Two Cents, and we are getting ready to hear a treat, a lesson on the weapons of our warfare by Marlene. She's dealing with one of the weapons, which she will tell you in 1 second. God bless you, Marlene.
Yes, I am coming from Ephesians 6:14, and it says, stand firm with the belt of truth buckled around your waist. And what that means that it has to be the buckle of truth. When we look at all of our weapons, from the shield of faith and the different weapons that we have, the belt of truth is the belt that keeps everything afloat. So that belt, when it's the truth, it has to be the source of the word of God. That truth has to be our understanding of God's law, and it has to be his word. So this is how we get our understanding. This is how we get our wisdom. And sometimes we find ourselves looking at man and looking at the books that people have written, and we'll find ourselves knowing more about the books that people have written as opposed to understanding what God's word says. And even when we look at repentance and how we view it, because the most important, the beginning of salvation is repentance. And that is us being true to ourselves and being first true to ourselves and then being true to God. And we have to be true and honest with ourselves before we can even be honest with God. And it all stems from the power of the word of God. And that means whether it's someone that you're looking at as your leader that must bear fruits of the Spirit, the Spirit of, and walk in the fruits of the Spirit. And sometimes we see success and we mistake success and prosperity with and replace it and take that and use it instead of seeking the understanding that your first ministry begins at home with your family and your parents and your wife and children with your parents and being obedient to your parents and these things, but everything comes back to this word of God as your standard, because if you don't stand for something, you'll fall for anything. This is how a lot of false religions are made, where they take half truth and give you half truth of, and you believe some and you know some, but it's looking and having this word as your standard, having this belt of truth that holds everything up, that that Jesus Christ died on the cross for me. That is his blood that redeems me. How do I know that? Because it's in his word. Not because somebody says it, but because I read it in God's word. Because as my pastor gave me the sermon, but I went back and I researched it and I looked. And yes, and God speaks to you in many ways. And a lot of times, through the word of God, he convicts you. Through the word of God, he uplifts you, heals you, and does different things through his word. So that word has got to be something that we use as our standard. And it can't be the knowledge of man, because a lot of times that knowledge might be someone's opinion and it may be somebody that you respect, but we have to right now be really, really discerning of how we view things and what we allow in our spirit, because we're in a time where we're living in the last days and the enemy is very deceptive and cunning now, because they know, he knows that his time is short. So he's coming in so many different ways, and that way is deceit, and that way is deception. And it says, my people perish for a lack of knowledge. A lack of knowledge because you reject the knowledge. What is knowledge? It's the knowledge of the word of God. Knowledge of this power and what it, the power that it has, how I'm supposed to live my life. Because as much as I may go to church and may listen to my pastor can only do one thing for me. And that's preach the word. But it's up to me to walk in obedience and to even understand what it is to do those things, because we came in this world by ourselves and we're going to leave by ourselves. We're going to be judged by ourselves. So we have to be wise as serpents and harmless as doves. Mm-hmm. And that wisdom comes through the word of God. And it's so powerful and it's so edifying when you can listen and understand, because you know the word of God. Because you have this belt plate, this belt of truth that's powerful, because that belt is holding everything else up. So your faith, where does your faith come? It comes through the power and the word of God, hearing and obedience and different things that you do in your life to help build your faith through your, even your trials and your mistakes. But everything, it goes back to that word of God from Genesis to Revelation. And some people are saying that they believe, you know, they're chopping up the Bible where they don't believe the New Testament and they believe just the old, but it's all of it, because it's like a cake mix. When you put all the ingredients in and you mix it together and you bake a cake, because the same spirit that from Genesis to the book of Revelation, the Holy Spirit that led these prophets and disciples to write this word, this powerful word, that we have to have faith in, an unyielding faith to the word of God. And I don't focus on things that I have no control of, but I focus on my prayer with God, him revealing things to me, and this word of truth, that the Lord will reveal his truth to me. Because that word that says gift come without repentance. So people may sound good, they may prophesy good, they may sing good, they may do all these things, but it goes without repentance. But this word of God is an unadulterated truth that no man, it will not come back void. This is powerful and it is mighty. And there's coming a time where we're going to have this word of God in our hearts, because sometimes you like, as you heard, you may have the spiritual warfare through your mind, but it's going to come through these scriptures and this word and that power that you may have to fight the enemy with. So 1 Corinthians 2:14, it says, the natural person does not accept the things of the Spirit of God, for they are folly to him, and he is not able to understand them, because they're not able to spiritually discern. And it's basically saying that you can't look at, expect people that's in the world and people that don't honor God's word and to understand things of the world. So that's why it's so important for us to know what the word of God says and to let that be our foundation. It has to be the root of our foundation for everything. And if it goes against it, no matter how it appears, no matter how it may look, then we have to turn away from it, because it is not of God. Because it says in the scriptures, Lord, 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 didn't we prophesy in thy name and cast out demons? But the Lord is going to say, depart from me, ye worker of iniquity, I never knew you. And that's saying that because, you know, it's people that gift goes without repentance, people that can do these things but they're going against this word. And this word of truth is beginning with yourself, taking a self-reflection of your life, your sins, and your iniquity, and lining it up with the word of God. And having an intimate relationship with the Lord through his word, and letting him lead and guide you with your prayer life, with everything that we do on this earth is a spiritual fight. It's a spiritual battle. It happens in the spirit before it manifests in the physical, and everything. And that's what it's all. But where does your wisdom come from? Where does your knowledge come from? It comes from the word of God. How do I learn to be a virtuous woman? How do you learn to be a man of God, of integrity, a man after God's own heart? It's through this word that teaches you how to live, how to stand, convicts you that these things that we are required to do ourselves. So that's just my take on the truth and how important it is for the word of God to be your standard, and not no pastors, not no prophets, but you, for what you have read from Genesis to Revelation, from the prayers that you pray when you go, when you shut your door, when you decide to go on a fast and ask God to work in your life, to do the things that it takes to see God work. You know, to see him work in your life and manifest and do things. And a lot of the works that the Lord does in your life are blessings to the free you from bondage and different things that are spiritual in terms of bearing fruits of the Spirit and being able to overcome generational curses and different things. Sometimes we get so focused on the material things and thinking that these are the blessings. But and seeing how far you've come, you know, from last year or year before, saying, wow, now, you know, I spend a lot more time in prayer. You know, before I got so angry, but now it doesn't bother me. Now, you know, that doesn't bother me because the Lord is freeing you and delivering you. And you know where that comes from? At the feet of the Lord. And that's what it comes from. So that's my take on the how important it is about this belt of truth that is so powerful, with the word of God being your truth, not man's word, not man's books, not these things that we put so far ahead. How many books have we read that were written by man, by your pastor, but haven't read the word of God, haven't, and don't even understand it, but know what you, don't even understand to study it, this knowledge that you need to fight this enemy. But this, and this is what we must turn away from and turn to. So that's my take on it. Thank you.
Wow. Thank you very much. I appreciate you going through all that work. I hope you take this to heart. God bless you.